Good morning. Welcome to Kids Worship. Let's go ahead and begin with our Bible verse. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Matthew 6, 9 through 13. We have already learned all the way to here. We are really moving fast through the Lord's Prayer. We are going to learn the next sentence. It says, and forgive us our debts. We'll talk about this more later, but basically forgive our sins as we forgive our debtors, as we forgive other people who've done things not nice to us. So forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Let's say that four more times. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Okay, you'll find out that in our lesson today, there's going to be a sheep. And so to practice our memory verse, we're going to follow along word by word. And if we come to the letter A, we are going to be sheep, and we're going to make it sound like, got it? Here we go. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Okay, you can try saying the whole verse like a sheep, but just keep practicing, keep praying, keep talking to God. Prayer is communicating with God. Right now, go ahead and listen to our song about prayer by Stephen Curtis Chapman.
Let us pray, everywhere and every way, every moment of the day, it is the right time.
Jesus taught. Remember, a parable is a story that has a special meaning. Jesus would teach things by telling a story because it was easier for people to remember a story and what the story meant than just learning the meaning to start with. So far we learned the wise and foolish builders. Jesus wasn't trying to teach us how to build a house. He was trying to encourage us to build our lives on Him, to make Him and living for Him, knowing that God loves us, the most important thing, so we'd have a strong foundation. Then we talked about the farmer. Once again, Jesus wasn't trying to teach us how to be good farmers. Instead, the different kinds of dirt that the seeds fell onto were different ways that we can hear God's word. And He wanted us to be the good dirt that heard His word and thought about His word and talked about His word and learned about His word so that we could grow and grow and grow in Him. Last week, we actually did two parables, but they were really short and they had the same meaning. It was the mustard seed, started out tiny, grew into a great big plant, and the leaven, that little bit of yeast, you know, that you put in with the bread and it makes it all puffy. That's what we learned about, starting out small, growing big, and it said that that's what the kingdom of God was like. Just a few people knew about Jesus and what salvation was, but then more and more and more and more people learned, and so now there's many, many, many people who are part of God's forever family and who love and serve God. Today we're actually going to do two more parables, but again, they have the same meaning, different meaning than last week. So the first one starts out, from our memory verse, with starts out with the sheep. So there was a shepherd, and he had 100 sheep. Maybe you would like to count to 100. But when you get to the number 99, stop. Because as that shepherd was counting his sheep, he realized one of his sheep was missing. He went back and counted again, and still there were only 99. He knew he was supposed to have 100 sheep, but he only had 99. So, do you think that shepherd decided, I don't need 100, 99's good? Of course not. The shepherd left his 99 sheep all safe and sound, and he went out looking for that one lost sheep. And he searched and he searched and he searched and he searched and he kept looking and looking and looking everywhere he could look. He looked down in the ravines. He looked out on the open grass. He looked in the bushes. He looked everywhere for that little sheep that was lost until he finally found it. And once he found that little sheep, he just grabbed that sheep right up and he put him on his shoulders and he hiked back into town and he gathered up all of his neighbors, all of his friends. He said, "Look, I found my sheep. My sheep was lost and I found it. Oh, be happy with me. Rejoice with me. My sheep is found." Jesus said, "That's how heaven is. Because God is very, very happy when one sinner returns to God or turns to God or comes to God." Does that mean that God doesn't care about everybody else? Of course God cares about everybody else. Just like the shepherd cared about his other 99 sheep and he had gone out looking for them the same way. But God cares even for that person who doesn't know him, who's not part of his forever family, who hasn't learned about Jesus' salvation and learned it and heard it and read it and talked about it and accepted it. God cares about each one. It says heaven rejoices when that one sinner comes to God. Jesus went on, he told another parable. This one's about a woman. And this woman had 10, much easier to count to 10, coins. These are special silver coins, valuable coins. And one day she had them out and she was counting them. She loved her coins. She's looking at them and she's counting. When she got to the number 9, there wasn't a number 10. So she went back and counted again. Still missing a coin. She kept counting and she kept coming up with 9. She knew she was supposed to have 10 coins. Once again, the woman didn't say, 9's good enough. No, 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 no. She turned on she lit the lamp, got the house all nice and bright with light. She got out her broom. She starts sweeping every nook and corner, moves all the furniture, looks under everything that's on the floor until finally she finds that 10th coin. And she too goes running to the neighbors. She runs to her friend's house. "Be happy with me. Rejoice, rejoice. I found my coin that was lost." Jesus said, that's like the kingdom of heaven. The angels rejoice when one sinner repents. So what was the point? What's the same? They had a lot. Shepherd had 100 sheep. Only one got lost. But he rejoiced over that one. He went and looked and searched and searched and searched for that one because he cared about it till he found it. The woman had 10 coins. She lost one, and she searched and searched and searched until she found it. And then she rejoiced. Did the shepherd love the other 99 sheep? Yes, he did. Did the woman want and care about the other 9 coins? Of course she did. Does God love everybody who's part of his forever family? Yes, of course he does. Does he love that person who still doesn't know who he is? Who still is, maybe the seed fell on the path and it was snatched away and he hasn't heard, he hasn't understood. Maybe the weeds choked it out and he just got so busy that he wasn't paying any attention anymore to God or growing. God is happy when those people turn to him and become part of his family, part of the ones that have their roots going down good in that good deep soil and growing in his love and becoming strong in him. Let's pray. Dear God, we know you love all of us, everybody. Help us to love everybody and care about them too. Amen. So in your packet this week, you have a piece of cotton that is for you to just glue onto your color sheet with the shepherd. It'll make your sheep a little bit more fun and realistic. And then you have 10 coins. So if you have someone who will play with you in the house, hide one coin. Take turns finding that lost coin. Have a great week, and I'll see you on Wednesday.